Today I have a very interesting interview question, which is about the reverse proxy. The question goes like this: why is reverse proxy used in system design? What is the difference between reverse proxy and the load balancer? So let's understand where the reverse proxy fits into the system design. If you look into any system design diagrams or any architecture, you always see something like this, right? You will have the clients. The client in turn will connect to the load balancers. The load balancers will in turn connect to the multiple app servers like this, right? So then a reverse proxy comes in between the app servers and the load balancers like this. So let's understand why reverse proxy is required. So I can say it is required for multiple purposes, but we look at the three different purposes, like, you know, the security. So let's say if you see into this application server, a lot of security features will be put in the firewall or inside the load balancers, right? So now if you want to add more security, you can add the security policies or rules inside the reverse proxy, right? For example, if you want to do an HTTP authentication, you can have that inside the reverse proxy rather than having an individual app servers. And you can also have something like encryption of the SSL. So when you have a HTTPS protocol, the call comes from the load balancer to the app server. So the encryption and decryption can be done in the reverse proxy layer rather than doing in the application servers, right? The reverse proxy server can also be used to improve the performance of the application. So for example, if you have the JavaScript or HTML, instead of having that in the app server, you can have in the reverse proxy server. In that way, you know, the load balancer need not reach the app server to get the JavaScript and HTML content, which is static, and it can directly go to the reverse proxy and get those content. The second thing is, reverse proxy server can also be used on the cache server, right? So if you want to have some of the information to be cached, you can have that directly in the reverse proxy server rather than placing everything in the app server. So the load balancer can go to the reverse proxy server to get the cache information. What happens over this? It improves the speed and it reduces the latency. That's how the performance can be improved by having the reverse proxy. And the third one is, we can have reverse proxy server to optimize the content. For example, if you see in most of the content going from the client to app server, they may be requiring the zzip compression. So this zzip compression, we need not have to place in the app server. Instead, you can have in the reverse proxy. So whatever the content going from the client to the server or from the server to the client, it can be zzipped and it can be sent to the client or it can be sent to the server based on the necessity. So that is why you call it as a, you can use the reverse proxy server to optimize the content. So what it happens is, it reduces the bandwidth and obviously it also helps to improve the performance of the system, right? Let's talk about the second question, that's what's the difference between the reverse proxy and the load balancer. So what does the reverse proxy do? Reverse proxy actually accepts the request from the client, forwards it to the server that can fulfill the client request and returns the server response back to the client, right? But if you look into the load balancer, it does almost similar operation, but there is a slight difference. So load balancer comes into the picture when there are n number of clients or millions of client requests coming to the server, right? So load balancer, what it does is, it distributes the traffic across multiple reverse proxy servers or multiple application servers. So load balancer is primarily used to distribute the traffic to improve the performance, right? Whereas the reverse proxy is used as a front face to take some of the responsibility of the application servers, right? And for the load balancer, I have a detailed video and I'll put that in the description. And if you have any questions or comments, please put it in the comment section. That's it I have. Thanks for watching. Bye.